Hi, hello, and maybe even welcome back to a new video. It's Gina here, and welcome to my art corner. For today, I have again a new video for you guys, and it's all in traditional art. Yay! Also because it's October, which is normally for me Inktober or something similar to it, I decided to redraw a character that I actually didn't draw in October, but do it last year at the beginning of the year around. I will put the old drawing here somewhere on the screen and then you can see the comparison. I really wanted to redraw her for quite some time actually, and I thought because, you know, October is kind of the spooky and witchy kind of month, I thought drawing a witch would be really good. So I just started with it, and to be honest, I don't have the sketch for you guys because I didn't thought I would actually make it like this. Like, I don't know, I just started to sketch and like redraw her or like resketch her, but I didn't thought I would make a like totally fleshed out piece with everything and such. I just don't know. I didn't know if I would actually record her. That's the best way. And it's again a little bit longer of a video, but I thought I would chat with you guys a little bit about October, Inktober, why I don't participate really, why a lot of people are like going against it and everything, and just tell you as much as I know. Like, I didn't see way too much into it, or look way too much into it, to be honest. Because, well, this year's already crazy enough. So, let's talk about why I don't really participate. In October, I have again an eye appointment with my eye doctor and everything, and my feeling is telling me that maybe it won't stay with one appointment. And being all like super mega nervous of hoping that it won't be like last year's December, where I had to go to so many appointments and everything, ending up in the hospital and everything. I just really hope that it won't be like that, because if you don't know, if you're new, I have a really silly, not like it's not silly, but no one really knows what is going on with my eyes. So I had quite a few tests. I had blood tests and everything, and nothing seems really that off, but my eyes are showing something. So yeah, I don't know. I don't see well. Like I can see, but my eyes are already not that good. Like, I had to wear glasses since I was a little child, but now I even have this thing that I need to wear contact lenses in between, so my eyes aren't really that round that they should be, but it's more like little hills and everything, so the light isn't going in as it should go in. And well, one of my eyes, my left eye, is especially bad, and it's not enough that it's like that, but having this condition that not like no one can explain what is going on is really stressing me out enough. So I won't participate in Inktober like I did for 3 years. I succeeded, so it's okay. And I will just do the small redraws and make a little bit of drawings that suit October and Halloween and everything, but not really participate in Inktober. And also, I forgot to say at the beginning of the video, I have a star guest in my video, and it's my curly hair. I don't know why, but in this, like, when I was recording this, normally I really try not to go that much into the drawing, like I used to, but in this I kind of forgot it, and it's not that bad because you still see the drawing itself, so it's not like my head is pushing into the way. But you will always see a little bit of curves there on the left side. I'm really sorry. I don't know. I was deeply into a conversation while I was drawing this. Maybe that was why I didn't pay attention, but actually I was and still not. But yeah, it happens. And as you can see, this time I'm not using own inks or something like that, so like I said, I don't participate directly in Inktober, and many don't do either. And why is that? So if you're not an artist, or maybe an artist that didn't get the information, and I still didn't watch the video, to be honest, I heard a lot, I read a lot, and not only that, Jake Parker, that actually, and this is not like any, I don't know Jake Parker, like I know his videos and everything, but I don't know him personally, so I'm going only with what I've heard. I don't know if it's like true, but the first thing that many people didn't like was he wanted to make the Inktober copyrighted, and that would mean a lot of problems with people because he never copyrighted it, so like it was alright. Everyone drew Inktober drawings and even sold little Inktober scenes, like calling them actually Inktober. And if it did go with the copyright thing, of course they couldn't sell that anymore because it's not theirs, because it's Inktober and it's his thing. So that was the first thing that seemed to upset a lot of people, and to be honest, I kind of get it. Like, if he wanted to like copyright this, he should have made it from the beginning and not like years later, because a lot of people just like sold pieces and scenes and so on with the Inktober drawings and Inktober name and everything. So I think that was one step that made a lot of people angry with him. And the second thing that I've got to know now and read a little bit, I still haven't watched the video about the guy that actually says that it seems like Jake Parker did a little of a, okay, let's say a pretty big mistake there. So this guy, an artist, I think, like I said, I didn't watch the video yet, but I think it's a dark-skinned artist, and he made this Inktober kind of book. And so Jake Parker also made a book, of course, because he was the one that started with Inktober and everything, and I think it's okay. The only thing is that it seems that the both of the books are very, very similar, and of course you can go just only with this and that way with ink, so that's okay, but it seems quite a lot of things are way too similar to be even like just like, yeah, you know, this can happen. And so many people are like, now, did he steal it? Did he take too much reference from another artist? And so on. So the questions linger in the air, and as I've said, I didn't watch the video of the artist that says, okay, hey, the similarities are a little bit way too much. And if it's true, like, it's a little bit like, if you know more about this, let me know. I still need to watch the video, and I didn't want to just like go way too bad against one artist, because as I've said, I don't know either of them really personally and everything. So I'm trying to get the, like at first I was like, oh gosh, now everyone going against Jake Parker, what is going on? Because I just didn't get it. I didn't get it because everyone loved Jake Parker, actually, because of Inktober. because this Inktober made so many artists come together on this month, and of course there are now different things like Mermaid and so on, and Huvember, but somehow Inktober was something that so many participated, and now many are like, okay, I'm drawing with ink, but actually I won't call it Inktober, but make it like OCtober or Cattober and so on, so or like Drawtober, and so many different, like it was already there. Like I know that one year, I believe in 2018 or 17, I made Witchtober kind of, because I drew with ink but drew a lot of witches with different flowers and everything. So yeah, it always was there, to so you could use different prompt lists and everything, but this year especially it seems that more and more people used not his prompt list, not his Inktober official prompt list, because they were angry, because they are angry. I mean, we are still in Inktober, and it's kind of sad because a lot of people like enjoyed Inktober always, and some smaller or bigger artists are like a little bit confused to, is it okay if I use the prompt list of the official Inktober prompt list, because everyone is kind of going against it, but at the same time some people just like don't really want to help him but just really love Inktober. And to be honest, if I didn't have this going around with my eye condition and everything, I would be like, I don't know if it's okay to do Inktober the way, like normally I never used only his prompt list, I always used especially one that I liked, or mixed it up myself and just used different prompt lists. But it's a little bit sad that something that amazing is a little bit pushed behind and hated on right now. And Inktober is already way bigger than Jake Parker, to be honest, because as I've said, there isn't anymore just that you have to draw with ink, but also it's like more, you have your own prompt list, you don't have to use the ones from Jake Parker, so you can make Inktober and just call it differently like most people do. So it's already bigger than he anticipated it, and even if he would go in with, okay, I make this my own, like Inktober is mine, all mine, still there will be like ink drawings that just are called maybe differently, and some don't even do ink drawings but really do like this Drawtober, so draw each day of October. And I think what most people forget is that it's about the challenge of drawing each day, because many artists just can't or don't do that, and I did it for a whole year, like drawing each day, and I'm really thinking about starting next year again to draw at least every second day, because right now I just feel so like, I don't know, I did get into that phase again where I'm sketching and inking on one day and color it the another day, and I think it's not bad because art hasn't been to be rushed, or don't need to be rushed, but at the same time I'm just like, my gosh, I could do so much more and I don't, but just, I don't know, to be honest, because after December, I still had to go to some appointments in January, and I was just exhausted for a long, long time, to be honest, and didn't talk that much about this in videos yet. Like, you know, at the beginning of the year I talked about that I have this condition and everything, or at the end of the year last year, I don't know anymore, but I didn't like talk about the in the videos that I actually was like, it took me a few months to actually get like energetic again, I could say, or not that like I was so exhausted, and I had I had my times where I just didn't know anymore. Like, I knew that I did something, like, not like that. I did something and sat down, and a few minutes later, I had to go check if I did it or I didn't remember. And I even told my friends that if I repeat myself, I'm super sorry, my head is just like, probably because of the thing that I was so exhausted and just because I was so stressed, like I never was so stressed in my life. And I'm okay now, most of the way at least, and it just I'm really hoping to get into things a little bit more again. I'm trying my best, and also with my videos, like normally I would upload 2 videos a week, and right now I'm mostly uploading once a week if I'm not like don't feeling well or forgetting it and just upload it the next week. So yeah, I will try my best to get a little bit back into the groove like I used to be. And it took me quite some while. I know the year is almost at the end, and wow, this year was a roller coaster for everyone in some kind of way, and it's not even over. So let's see what October, November, and December will bring us, guys. But yeah, maybe I should talk about the drawing a little bit more, and just because, you know, it's the drawing that you can see here and the redraw, and I'm super glad how she did turn out. I'm thinking about naming her, making her an original character, because I already drew her once and then as a mermaid, and now a redraw, and I totally dig this new outfit that I gave her. Like, I was tempted to draw her dress, but as I was sketching, I was just like, how the hell do you even like sit on a broom when you wear a dress? And like, I tried to cover her up back then. I know that I just didn't know what to draw, and I still have problems with outfits, but this one without referencing, I'm super glad. I thought it would be super cute having the same like color scheme like in the old one, so being this purplish bluish kind of color with black. And so I thought I would give her some pants that have this kind of, oh my gosh, how it's called, pattern. It's not called pattern, but I will just call it like pattern. And having this top which is half see-through and everything, so I'm just really happy. And I really like that her eyes and her hair contrast her dark outfit so much. Like, she's a little witch, but also this cute little witch that I kind of think she's a little bit more grown up than in the first drawing. And I just really, really enjoyed designing her, and I will do maybe one where she's standing, and maybe like with my Satomi one, making a few more sketches to get her to know a little bit better and everything. Like, I'm really trying, not just trying, I really want to draw more of my original characters and give them more love, because they deserve it, and I have quite some that I really make into original characters. And I'm still thinking about the name. I was thinking, like, I didn't told that anyone till now, but I was thinking about calling her something like Mimi, Mimiko, or something like that. I don't know, but just like, I looked at her and somehow in my mind I was hearing like Mimi, Mimiko, something like that, because she's like Mickey, Mini, I don't know. It's just like something with M, I believe. I don't know why even. Normally I often try to look up names with meanings and everything, but sometimes I just have like, maybe I just call her like that, you know? And with this character, she's just so adorable. I don't know. I really wanted to have her adorableness still in this drawing, but make her a little bit, like, not just make her a little bit, like, have her in my new style. And I'm actually quite proud of this, to be honest, even if I made the mistake to draw her way too low. So one of her feet is cut off. I'm sorry, but it had to be. They just, like, I had too much of the sketch on the reactor, and I didn't want to erase it just because of the food. So, it's all right. It's all right, I hope. And also, I'm super, super proud. Like, in the old drawing, you can see that I had this little round background that isn't actually really a background. It's kind of like this sky, dark, dark sky with a little bit of stars and everything. And I actually was thinking about adding this gold stars again, or this dots on her outfit, but I really liked it this way, even if I think the top would be cute with a little bit of gold. So maybe I will change it up later, but it's not, I'm not sure. So with the background this time, I was thinking about, should I, my hair. I'm so sorry, guys. I really don't, I don't know what this. Bye. Here? Hello? Go away. Go away. Yeah? No? Okay. But, yeah. I was thinking about doing the circle behind her again, but she's a little bit bigger on the page, and it's only a A5 page, so doing a circle behind her, I don't know. I didn't feel like it, so I was like, okay, maybe make this cut out background again. So I made this kind of shape behind her and just started to fill it in. And this time I wanted it to be really kind of a night sky, maybe a little bit dramatic of a night sky, but I thought it would suit her having this same color scheme as herself, like this. Like, I'm going again a little bit faster than you see, so I will wait. And as you can see, I'm using some colored pencils too, and I just really love drawing with markers and colored pencils. And it's just so soft. I don't know why, but on this paper, the colored pencils are so super soft, like they feel so good on it. I totally have to make one piece that is only with colored pencils in the sketchbook. And yeah. I just really, to be honest, I totally love drawing her. She's so adorable, and having her redrawn, even if the skin is a little bit pale, but you know, it's all right. It's late. She's a witch, so maybe she's more outside when it's late, so she doesn't get this nice suntan everything, you know. And here I'm starting with the background, and I used, as I've said, the pretty much same color scheme as she has, so like with this pinkish, purplish kind of colors. And I really wanted to try to go from light to dark, and it wasn't easy because my lightest colors are like from the Spectrum Noir brush markers, and I love them, that's not a problem, but they feel kind of a little bit drier. Like the ooh-hoos are juicy, like wow, they are so juicy, like I love them. I wish they would have ruffle things for them because they are just really great. I mean, if any product could, like, no, actually the Spectrum Noir markers are also really good. They are very, very good, but I wish more markers would have really this refills. Like, Spectrum Noir is actually saying they have, but I never did find any, or like in colors that I just don't need. So I'm a little bit confused with this, but yeah, I can say I'm trying backgrounds, even if they're simple, but I'm so glad that I actually did draw the background, because at first I was like, I don't want to ruin this, like always, you know, having a background that maybe just makes it worse or something like that. But this time I'm so glad I did, because it's just really looking like this cool illustration with having a background and everything. And it's just pretty. It's just pretty. Like, I still don't know. I can choose, like, I try my best to remember how to say this word, but you know, it's gorgeous. It's gorgeous. And At the end, I even added a little bit of like having this mountain, having this city behind her, like she's feeling flying up high. And I just really, really like, I love it. Can I say that I love it and I love her? And made her use a little bit of magic and everything. And I am glad with the end results. I hope you like this too. And I just remember how this thing is called. It's called lace. Ha! I did remember it, even if it's the end of the video. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. If you like this, then maybe subscribe for more. And hopefully I will see you then in the next video. See you then. Bye bye.